Hey everybody, I wanted to take a quick minute and walk you through how to insert your video or embed your video on your Google slide so that when you are doing your presentation, you can play your video right here inside of the slide deck. Now, I think it's important because depending on where you're presenting it and how you're presenting it and what kind of devices and things like that, if you just put the link in here, you click on it, it's going to take you out of Google Slides to YouTube or wherever to do the video, and which isn't going to be so wrong. But what happens then when you're done watching that video, you have to come back. And so depending on the device you're doing or how comfortable you are using that device to do the presentation, it could be a little difficult, okay? Also, we have a couple of options that we can play with inside of Google Slides if we embed the video here. So let's walk through and show you how to do this real quickly. So first off, we're going to get us a video. And what I am going to do is, let me copy this link really quick. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to do insert video, okay? And it gives me some options here. Now, I could search YouTube. I could search for the video right here, okay? You are within the EVSC. You do have the safe search on, so it's only going to give you access to videos that you can't use. Now, if there are other videos, and again, depending on how you are going to be presenting and if you are able to access that video in that presentation, you could bring in your own video from, like you could do your search on your device, get the link and bring it back. And you can put that link right here, okay? You could also go in and do a Google Drive, and that would be if you created a video and you saved it into your drive, you could upload it into there. You just have to be kind of careful of the playback format. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to lift in here Sparks Fly, which I think is a completely underrated song. I think we need more of that. When you hit insert video, it's going to place it on the slide. Now, depending on the layout and the design and the defaults, whatever, it's going to lay it somewhere on that slide. But you can move it to wherever you want. So I'm going to just go ahead and lay it right here in the middle, okay? And notice the red lines there that help you get that center. Or if you have like a piece of text and then you put the Google slide under or the image or video or whatever under it, it'll also create those red lines so you can help center under those elements. I can also resize this if I wish by grabbing these corner dots. If I grab the corner, it changes the height and width at the same time. If I grab one of these center dots, notice it only changes one dimension and now your picture or your video gets distorted and out of proportion. So always grab in the corners, okay? And again, I'm going to go ahead and just resize. After I've resized, I'm going to reposition this, right? And there you go. Your video is now inside of your your slide, and you're ready to embed. It's embedded, and now you can play it inside the slide while you're presenting. You do have some options, like you can put in a drop shadow or something here, depending on the theme and what you're doing, you know, how that looks or what that kind of how that appears, whatever, right? I'll put that in there just for fun. You can change the position so you can tell it exactly where you want to go if you have like some ideas of the dimensions, or you can just, again, move it wherever you want. Size and rotation, again, you can scale it, you can change it, you can do those kinds of things, just like your images. The one element that I really want to point out to you is this playback feature, okay, the video playback. This is how you tell Google Slides, how you tell Google Slides you want it to play inside of this. Now, if I do this play on click, that means that anywhere on the screen that I tap, it'll start the video. Now, again, depending on what you're doing and how you're going to do it, that may be a decent option, right? It also has this option for play automatic, which means that as soon as you open up this slide, it's going to start playing the video. Again, that could be really cool if you're doing some sort of, with some kind of special feature, or you want to do that as part of the presentation where you're like, hey, let's take a look and see what we got. And you click and it pops right up automatically, right? So again, those are a couple options for you. The one I really recommend though for our use in this class is the click on the manual. And what that does is that makes you hit the actual play button. And the reason, and again, you know, as you get into the slides and as you are practicing and as you are kind of perfecting your use of the device and the slides, you know, you can use some other options. But the reason I like this one is because let's say that you open, you click, you have it on play on click, right? And so the slide comes up, you tap on the board, it plays the video. When you tap on the board to go to the next screen, it's going to play the video again. So you have to tap it again, right? And so sometimes it makes the presentation not as flow as well, or makes it a little awkward, or you just have to be kind of careful with your presentation. But inside of this one where it says play manual, you actually have to play the YouTube play button to make the video go. And then you can just tap anywhere on the screen, and so you're good to go. Also too, you'll notice that I left some space around the sides of the video. Again, I could make it full screen. That wouldn't be a problem. I can make it run off the screen. I could even, like, you know, only one corner of it on the screen or whatever. I have a lot of options there. I do like to leave some space around the sides because then, again, I can tap on the board and it will go to the next slide. So I've clicked on this play manual. Now here, I can tell it where I want it to start and where I want it to end, right? And for our speech presentations, remember you have 30 seconds of video that you can show while you're not speaking, right? And so this tells Google Slides, open up this video, start here, and stop here. As with everything, I really recommend that you practice this in advance, meaning that you know that the video is going to load, you know there's not a bunch of ads or anything that you have to click through. Also, too, it has that catch version inside of the memory so that when you do click on it, it's not loading, 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 and playing, that you've already got all that set up. So I went ahead and I put mine. By the way, you do have the option to mute the video or mute the audio so that you don't hear anything. And again, if that was something like you wanted to talk over, or maybe like the video was good, but people in the background were saying inappropriate things or something, you could turn that off as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to hit my slideshow here to pull it up as if I were presenting. Now notice I've got the YouTube play button here. The video pops up. It didn't play automatically. I'm going to hit that play button. It's going to jump to 220. We're going to get the hair flip, the infamous hair flip back in the young days. There it goes. And then it's going to stop in 5, 4, 3, 2. There she stops. I was 1 second off, apparently. All right. So, again, that's how you embed the video. That is your best use of the presentation. You are welcome to do some other options if you so choose, like clicking out and going to, or if your website, if you have a video that's not on YouTube that you're using on a website, you will have to do that. But just make sure you are practicing those transitions and how you're using this. Good luck, everyone.